cited that hemodialysis pathway has the highest positive pressure. Blood entering the dialyzer fibers. Hemodialysis, arterial blood is conducted through tubing to a pump, which forces the blood through the hollow fibers in the dialyzer. The pre-pump blood usually has a negative pressure, while the post-pump blood, arterial header, about to enter the hollow fibers has the highest positive pressure, the value depending on the resistance of the fibers. Pressure then diminishes over the length of the fiber, and the pressure in the venous return is the lowest positive pressure in the system. The dialysis machine can control the pressure differential between the dialysate and the blood, the so-called transmembrane pressure. This may be adjusted to control the amount of fluid removal. The average pressure difference between blood entering and leaving the dialyzer fibers determines the net hydraulic pressure, forcing fluid out of the blood, through the membrane, and into the dialysate. In hemodialysis, arterial blood is conducted through tubing to a pump, which forces the blood through the hollow fibers in the dialyzer. The pre-pump blood usually has a negative pressure, while the post-pump blood, arterial header, about to enter the hollow fibers has the highest positive pressure, the value depending on the resistance of the fibers. Pressure then diminishes over the length of the fiber, and the pressure in the venous return is the lowest positive pressure in the system. The dialysis machine can control the pressure differential between the dialysate of the blood, the so-called transmembrane pressure. This may be adjusted to control the amount of fluid removal. The average pressure difference between blood entering and leaving the dialyzer fibers determines the net hydraulic pressure, forcing fluid out of the blood, through the membrane, and into the dialysate. Thank you. confirms the coefficient of the membrane refers to them. Fraction of solute that passes through the membrane by convection. As water moves through the membrane from the blood to the dialysate, convection, it drags molecules along with it. Solvent drag, the size of the molecule and the size and number of the pores in the membrane determine the fraction of solute that undergoes convective transport. Small molecules pass easily and quickly, but large molecules pass more slowly. The term sipping coefficient of the membrane refers to the amount of a given solute that passes through the membrane from the blood into the dialysate. A sipping coefficient of 1.0 indicates that 100% of a given solute passed through the membrane, while a sipping coefficient of 0.4 indicates that only 40% of a given solute passed through the membrane by a convective mechanism.
Sipping coefficient. Sipping.